sure. Come on up. Nobody likes her back there.
Howdy.
That's it. Gather around. I'm not starting till everybody's here.
Friends, hardworking souls of Chola Springs, gather round, gather round. Do you suffer from rheumatism, lumbago, acute chronic sciatic, neurologic or inflammatory pain? Well, I represent the only company that makes the genuine article that cures headaches, neuralgia, earache, toothaches, backache, swelling, sprains, sore chests, swelling of the throats, contracted cords and muscles, anxieties and ravaged nerves, stiff joints, wrenches, dislocations, cuts and bruises, and it adds vitality and vigor to the healthy man.
But can you prove it, old man?
Oh, I'm sure there's some customer here who could prove the qualities of it by taking a drink right now. You, sir, come up here. Step right up. That's the spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, pay close attention. This poor, wretched volunteer, entirely unknown to me, will demonstrate the effects of Dr. West Dickens' own patent tonic. Be you a cowpoke or athlete, this miraculous elixir developed with the wisdom of the East keeps the muscles supple and relaxes the cords. It loosens the joints and gives a feeling of youth and vigor to the whole system. Not possible, I hear you say. Well, doubt no longer. Faith can move mountains, but I ask not for faith. I am a man of science, and today science will be vindicated. Your eyesight is greatly improved. Is that not so, friend?
If you say so.
That's right, it is. You heard him. What a good sport you are, sir. Now, gaze over yonder at that porch. If you squint, you may just be able to make out the skull that's hanging there. Go ahead, friend. Shoot that skull and demonstrate the miraculous eyesight you now possess. Shoot the... Wait! He is still adjusting to his powerful new eyes. Try again, friend. The tonic may still be taking hold. Remarkable! The eyesight of an eagle, granted by imbibing Dr. West Dickens' own patent tonic.
Anybody can make that shot. This man is a fraud. If your eye's so damn sharp, why don't you try shooting my hat out of the air?
My friends, our test case has been challenged to shoot a gentleman's hat out of the sky above our heads.
You can fool these people, but you ain't fooling me. Right. Let's just see how sharp you is with a moving target.
Ready to shoot that hat.
I thought we was here to see mirrors.
Have you ever seen such an eye? Behold the power of the elixir, plucked out of the sky.
Hey, hey, what? You think you can put a hole in a man's hat and just walk away, do you? Hey, it don't work like that around here, mister. Come on, are you a man or not?
A challenge of battle has been offered to our volunteer. What pair for a display of Herculean brawn?
You want a broken nose, friend? You mess with
your
wrong
week.
All right, let's finish this. Time somebody taught you a lesson. Come on, hit me. Normally, I don't... You hit mighty soft for a man.
Can you believe your eyes?
You're dead now.
Skeptics and dissenters, irrefutable proof! Do not let this opportunity pass you by!
Look, he's over there. Go get
him! This ends now!
Watch out! He's got a gun!
Who the hell do you think you ain't leaving here alive. Ow! Oh,
marvelous shot, dear boy. The kind of deadly accuracy that can only be afforded by the West Dickens elixir. Come, I have plenty for all.
You'll be fine. Get out of my way.
Hey, where are you going?
Oh, I want a bottle. Get me a bottle, please. One of them, right here.
No harm in trying one bottle, I suppose.
Well, I think that went kind of well, don't you?
I'm just glad that my normal job involves either chasing after cattle or murderers. Not the likes of you, mister.
Don't be like that.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I'd like to say my goodbyes, head on back to the real world.
Wait, sir. I've been thinking about your predicament. And I think I may have an idea. I've been thinking I could be your cunning Odysseus. Beware of the Greeks bearing gifts, sir. Mm-hmm. Williamson had better beware. We will make them into Trojans.
I don't rightly get you.
I want you to go and see my old friend, Seth. He can come across as a little curious, but I'm sure you two will get on. He's most often found at Coote's Chapel. He's very devout.
Why see him?
Because between him and me, we can get those gates to open for you, and you can walk right in, just like in Homer's great Trojan yarn!